This episode is sponsored by Surfshark. Is SpaceX wasting money with their unflown starships? And when is Starliner finally going to launch again? Let's find out.
What about it? Go for launch.
We're go for launch. Let's light this candle.
Ignition sequence start.
My name is Felix and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? And today we'll dive into SpaceX's problem with unflown but fully built starships and super heavy boosters. Is it a waste of money after all? Let's dive right in.
Starship updates.
SpaceX is still waiting for the FAA decision, delayed twice and highly anticipated not only by SpaceX but also by the entire spaceflight community. It goes to show how much public interest really is behind SpaceX being allowed to proceed with their Starship test flights. But as said before, this doesn't mean that SpaceX is waiting around doing nothing. Quite the opposite. Many tasks do not require a test flight, so SpaceX is just busy upgrading its infrastructure and perfecting the design of the first orbital test flight candidates. Mauricio from RGV Aerial Photography was up in the air again for all of us, taking some stunning aerial pictures of what SpaceX is currently doing at their starbase. A link to his Patreon and Twitter can be found in the description. Make sure to check it out and consider supporting him. He deserves it. Booster 4 and Ship 20 sitting out at the launch site shows the fast progress more than anything else. Ship 20 right now in between the old suborbital pads and Booster 4 on a booster transport stand between the suborbital pads and where the Starship landing pad used to be. Ship 20 is arguably capable of at least reaching orbit, an orbital rocket never to be flown. Booster 4 is one of the largest rocket boosters ever built, without taking flight and sitting next to its heavily updated sibling Booster 7. Unusual, to say the least, and not common in the spaceflight industry. Rockets normally are built to be flown and not to be scrapped. So, is SpaceX wasting money and time? I got this question quite a few times in the comments under my videos and I read most of them. So let's try to answer it as best as possible. With SpaceX's approach to the Starship program and with extra time at hand given by the FAA, it does make sense to do it the Starbase way. Building a Starship prototype is not nearly as expensive as, for example, creating a NASA SLS, even though it's slightly bigger than its fancy NASA cousin. Wasting an entire Starship, including the booster, in favor of another, more advanced test candidate is cheap and fast. The production cost of a Starship and Super Heavy likely is below the $20 million mark, without engines even far less. Right now, and we're still in the prototype phase, it takes SpaceX around 3 to 4 months to build one pair of Starship and booster. Any other rocket constructing company in the world would love these times and prices, even when their products are in regular production and not still in the prototype phase. Again, take a look at SLS build times and price tags. It's an entirely different story. So no, even though SpaceX would have likely loved to get into the payload delivery business with their Starships yesterday, it isn't a waste of money not to launch Booster 4 and Ship 20. SpaceX is so fast at crunching out new test candidates with heavily upgraded hardware that it does make sense to skip some prototypes once in a while. Ship 21, for example, sitting at the SpaceX Rocket Garden now, has never been flown either. Full heat shield too. Even more advanced than Ship 20. In fact, the Rocket Garden is filling up so quickly that there is almost no room left. Ship 20 and Booster 4 wouldn't fit anymore. SpaceX will soon have to look for a different solution. The rapidly growing refinery at the old Sanchez site and next to the Rocket Garden won't move anywhere. It's one of SpaceX's most important assets at Starbase and it's growing further. New foundations are being made. One large patch in the middle can easily be spotted from Mauricio's vantage point. The site is buzzing with all sorts of construction work. Back at the launch site, Chief, the YCAM operator, was able to film SpaceX workers attaching a quick disconnect interface to Booster 7. These are preparations for further tests with this latest super heavy prototype on the Can Crusher. A hydraulic test stand putting Booster 7 through more crucial testing and preparation for the upcoming orbital flight. And a first test already happened on April 12th. After hooking Booster 7 up to the tank farm and to the Can Crusher itself, liquid nitrogen was filled into the very bottom of the engine section. It is likely to cool it down to flight temperatures to simulate flight conditions more accurately. Then the three hydraulic rams started pressing against Booster 7's thrust section to simulate engine thrust. The test almost exactly took 2 hours from the beginning of the venting to the end. No news from SpaceX, but there was no visible problem. Booster 7 has hit the next milestone and is getting more ready for the orbital flight every day. Fingers crossed for the FAA decision, SpaceX certainly seems more than ready to light the candle. What do you think? Will the FAA finally greenlight SpaceX at the end of this month? As always, tell me in the comments. If you liked today's episode so far, pause the video, hit the like button, subscribe if you regularly watch Why so that you don't miss any future releases, and maybe even become a channel member or a patron or buy yourself an awesome Why Wear shirt to support us and our upcoming endeavors at Cape Canaveral. Thank you so much. Crew 4 launch preview. Now let's take a look at the upcoming Crew 4 launch. When will it happen? What will be the payload? And what's the general state of the whole commercial crew program? Let's dive right in. The commercial crew program is in full swing. With SpaceX already having launched towards the ISS 4 times now, including Demo Mission 2 with Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley, they are keeping to their promise of giving the US access to space once again. Well, full swing might be wrong, as Boeing Space hasn't managed to get a single Starliner to the ISS, but more on that later. Now SpaceX is launching Crew 4 towards the ISS. After the successful Crew 3 launch on November 11th of last year, the stage is now set for a new expedition team to fly to the ISS and continue the work in low Earth orbit. NASA astronauts Kyle Lindgren, Bob Hines, Jessica Watkins, and ESA astronaut Samantha Cristoforetti will launch aboard a Crew Dragon spacecraft. The mission is scheduled to lift off no earlier than Saturday, April 23rd, from Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It's a so-called long-duration mission. The crew will spend several months at the ISS conducting science and maintenance aboard the orbiting laboratory before returning to Earth in the fall of 2022. The Crew 4 mission will fly a brand new Crew Dragon spacecraft and launch on Falcon 9 booster B1067.4. The number after the dot means flight number 4. It launched CRS-22 on June 3rd of 2021, Crew 3 on November 11th of 2021, and TurkSat-5B in 2021 and on December 19th. At SpaceX, it is a tradition that the first astronaut crew to fly a new capsule is allowed to name their craft. Crew 4 chose freedom to celebrate a fundamental human right and the industry and innovation that emanates from the unencumbered human spirit. Indeed, a fitting name in these times of war in Europe. The Crew 4 astronauts will conduct scientific research in material science, health technologies, and plant science to prepare for human exploration beyond low Earth orbit. In fact, many of NASA's experiments run at the ISS right now are focused on our future exploration plans for the inner solar system. Moon and Mars are within our grasp after all. Experiments will include studies on the aging of immune systems, organic material concrete alternatives, and cardiorespiratory effects during and after long-duration exposure to microgravity. These are just some of the more than 200 science experiments and technology demonstrations that will take place during their mission. The astronauts have also been training for a pair of spacewalks to continue preparing the station for new solar arrays to increase the station's total available power supply. Finally, they will also be aboard the ISS to welcome Boeing's Starliner for its second uncrewed orbital test flight, currently scheduled for May. December 20th of 2019, remember the date? I was live streaming it and we all watched Boeing Space launch their Starliner towards the ISS on OFT-1, the orbital flight test. Many things went wrong that day. bugged by hardware and software problems, the capsule could not reach the ISS and landed back on Earth 3 days later. But the problem didn't stop there. After a lengthy investigation, Boeing announced a privately funded OFT-2 mission towards the ISS, uncrewed again and first slated for October or November of 2020. Zero taxpayer money involved, all funded by Boeing. On August 25th of 2020, October or November 2020 turned into the first quarter of 2021 due to more software issues. Then March 2021 and August 2021. During the August 2021 launch window, issues were detected with propulsion system valves in the spacecraft before launch. The spacecraft had already been mated to its launch rocket, United Launch Alliance's Atlas V, and taken to the launch pad. Attempts to fix the problem while on the launch pad failed, and so the rocket was returned to the Vertical Integration Facility. They also tried to fix the issues inside the VIF, but were unsuccessful for the second time. Moisture sneaked into the valves and corroded them. And so Starliner's longer than expected journey continued. By late September 2021, Boeing was still unable to figure out the root cause of the problem. They decided to delay the flight indefinitely. The total cost of Starliner OFT-2 is now estimated to be around $595 million. Boeing is paying out of their own pocket, so that's a good thing to keep in mind. Since the faulty valves were located on the service module and Boeing was still unable to determine the cause, they decided to replace the entire service module in December of 2021. Now the plan is to launch Starliner OFT-2 no earlier than May this year, so a few more weeks. It is currently unknown how high the chances for the second launch are right now, but as said earlier, the SpaceX crew 4 astronauts will be waiting for it once again. No matter the outcome, Starliner is late, very late, and a few people at Boeing will likely be rather agitated at this point. Let's just hope that they can pull it off this time and that everything goes as planned for Team Starliner. It's sponsor time, but don't click away just yet. This might be more helpful than you think. Data and identity theft, traceability, intrusive advertising or geo-blocking, all those are part of the modern internet and we have to live with them, right? Not really. Surfshark VPN keeps your online identity safe by encrypting all information sent between your device and the internet. Also, a VPN swaps the real location of your device with a new one by changing your IP address. Have you ever been greeted with a message that this site or video is unavailable in your country? Streaming services like Netflix, Apple Plus, or Disney Plus, for example, have vastly different libraries in different countries. Surfshark makes you outsmart them easily by removing tracking cookies and the so-called geo-blocking from your account. Just activate your VPN, change your virtual location, refresh the page, and you're good to go for countless more Netflix and chill evenings. Surfshark is your one-stop and easy-to-use solution. Use my code to get 83% off plus 3 extra months for free and at the same time support What About It. Surfshark offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there is no risk. Surf with your own set of rules, links in the description. Today's supporter shoutout goes to Jan Beranek and over 1600 other patrons and channel members. Your help enabled us to improve Y from the beginning. Our first studio equipment was bought with your help. In fact, the lamps that are shining at me right now. And now you made our move to Florida possible. You're the greatest bunch of people we could have hoped for, and for that, the entire team at Y salutes you. Enjoy today's ad-free and early release. Remember to hop on our supporter exclusive Discord to chat with more than 1,200 like-minded supporters, including the entire team and me. And enjoy your upcoming weekends. You rock. Salt. Haha.
Oh, it's the orange cousin.
To get into the Well, some starships have flown in parts. Beginning of the venting. It is the venting, the German way of testing the rockets. Now let's take a look at the upcoming Crew 4 launch. Cristoforetti. Science experiments. Hey!